The apology still not, does not excuse the actions and policies of this government of the last 5 years. What arrogance to think that the people are so bodo that 5 years of anger are going to be swept away and forgotten by an apology and one day. Over the last 50 years, there's been a systematic erosion of your rights as citizens of this country. You have not been listened to for 5 years. No, make that 25 years. I don't want to make any more mistakes, so I'm going to quote Mr. Lee Hsien Loong directly. If we didn't get it right, I'm sorry. But we'll try better next time. I've been saying all along, their policies don't work. And finally, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong agrees with me. He got it wrong. Mr. Iswaran got it wrong. Mr. Lim Eng Kiang got it wrong. Not just on the individual block-to-block level, as we've seen, going from ward to ward on the ground, but on the national level. Let's look at what he said. For instance, if the government knew there would be a sudden surge in demand for HDB flats in mid-2009, and that foreigners would have created such congestion on the roads, it would have ramped up plans for more flats and MRT lines. So even Mr. Lee Hsien Loong thinks that it's okay to blame the foreigners, not himself. But what has happened over the last 10 years? Over the last 10 years, we've seen a million new immigrants come to Singapore. Over the last 10 years, the HDB has failed to build hardly enough flats for the surge in population. Actually, almost nothing. That's why the Reform Party plans to let you have the freehold of your HDB property, so you will own it. We don't want them to try better next time, and why would they, if after this election there's no pressure on them again for another 5 years? Lee Kuan Yew himself admitted once, the PAP must rejuvenate or stagnate. But this is a Prime Minister that laughs at the idea of raising funds on Facebook. He's out of touch and out of step. This is not a government that will rejuvenate. This is not a government that will ever pay attention to you. This is not a government that can retune its policies unless we put some competition upon them, real competition. And that means getting us into Parliament. That means at least 15 to 20 opposition MPs. Not NCMPs, not NMPs, not voices. Make no mistake, 10 years more of these wrong policies and we will never be able to recover. Mr. Lee Hsien Loong also had a snide laugh at the Reform Party. He said, if you don't have any candidates, you can ping-jump them from other parties. But don't worry, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong, if you don't have any policy ideas, you can ping-jump them from the Reform Party. And from me. And we'll teach you how to market on Facebook, too. Your apology is too little, too late. Now I want to touch on the cooling off period. Don't be fooled. It may be a cooling off period for us, but not for them. Their party political broadcast will dominate. We won't be able to respond. In any case, the cooling off period for the Reform Party started 10 days ago. There's been a blanket ban on us in the media. If you open the Straits Times today, where was the Reform Party? That's why you don't see our rallies, our press conferences, our comments on articles. Mr. Lee Meng-kyung can rebut our manifesto, but we don't get the right of reply. The PAP has total control of the traditional media. They seem very relaxed. They only bothered with one rally in West Coast. They've said there's only one hot seat in this election. They think they've fixed us in the media, but they underestimated us. That's why one of our first acts when we get into government will to be abolish the Newspaper and Printing Presses Act, so that we have a free media again. There was somebody else they tried to fix. 25 years ago, they tried to fix my father, J.B. Jeyaretnam. They thought they'd fixed him. They thought they'd fixed the opposition. But think about it. Who was it who got fixed? Who suffered because there was no voice to speak for them in Parliament? It was you. Don't you see that? They fixed you and they've been ignoring you ever since. And now they think they've fixed the Reform Party. And why do they need to do that? What are they so afraid of? They're afraid of me. But am I dangerous? I am the one voice they never want to hear again. And that is the voice of the Jeyaretnam. I know how you're going to make this government sit up and finally pay attention to you. By putting a Jeyaretnam back into Parliament. So cool off on Friday, but on Saturday, heat up again. I know you're scared, you may be scared. There's a movie that I like, it's called Spartacus, directed by Stanley Kubrick. And it's about the Roman slaves rising up against their masters. After they come close to overthrowing the Romans, they're finally defeated. And the Roman general says to the prisoners, "Tell me, which one of you is Spartacus? If you tell me, I will spare you." So first, one man stands up and says, "I am Spartacus." Then another man stands up and says, "I am Spartacus." And so it goes on. And finally, everybody stands up and says, "I am Spartacus." So when you go into the polling booth, what are you going to say? You're going to say, "I am JBJ. I'm not scared anymore." When you go into that polling booth, whether you are youth, male or female, a man or a woman, a grandfather or grandmother, I want you to vote like a lion. I want you to vote for Singapore. I want you to vote for liberty. I want you to vote for the Lion of Anson. Thank you.